How to create an abstract gradient design like this in Krita. Go to the layer menu and new and add paint layer. You will see a paint layer added there. Keep it selected, then right click and go down to add and add clone layer. So add clone layer, and that will add a clone layer based on that paint layer. So that paint layer is now going to be cloned. Anything you do in one will be appearing in the other. However, what you can also do is you can change the blending mode. So you can go to layers and you can go down here to negative. I must admit, there's so many of these ones that I always end up, and there is difference. I think there's about 150 of them. There's a lot of blending modes. Well, once you've done that, you can then right click this one and you can duplicate this layer. And that also will have difference. And you can repeat that. Again, right click and say duplicate layer or mask. So you've got three clones. Go to the Tools panel and select the Move tool. Go to the first clone layer and simply just drag. You can reposition it anywhere. Doesn't particularly matter, but I'll just move it slightly up. Go to the next one. And again, with the Move tool, just drag that up a bit further. And then select, obviously, the first one there and just drag that even more. Go to the Layers panel and select the Paint layer. That's the only layer you can add a gradient to. Clones, you can't. Once you've done that, go to the gradient tool, select that, then go up here to the gradients themselves. Click there and you can see all the gradients you've got. Not a huge selection. It's always a pity, really, but you can, of course, edit them and add your own and all those sort of things. I'm just going to go with this one. However, tool options. Got a nice selection here. You've got shapes. So you've got here linear, bilinear. I'm going to go with spiral. I love the spiral one, but reverse spiral also is great. Alternating, I think, gives us a nice smooth result. Forwards is fine, but alternating for this one. And then simply apply it. Just drag. And you can see the result. Now they're layers, and you can still move these layers. So you just go to the clone layer, select the clone layer. Again, go to the Move tool, and you can shift it. So you move it around, reposition it. Go to this one, move it around. And also, of course, you can always change the blend mode. You don't have to go with difference. Maybe go with darken or lighten or the 150 other ones that are available. Select a clone layer and convert it to a paint layer. Quite easily, layer and down to convert and convert to paint layer. Once you've done that, what you can do, you can now modify it in numerous other ways. Scale it, rotate it, etc. Apply effects and much, much more. However, what you can also do, if you decided that's it, I'm finished, you can always go to layer and you can say flatten image, just flatten the entire thing. So flatten image, and it's all one single design now. Now you will notice you've got these lines there, not particularly the greatest look. So you might want to crop your image. Just go over to the crop tool. There's the crop tool. Select that and then apply the crop to there. So you avoid obviously having those not particularly elegant looking lines, and press return. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Any questions, please leave in the comments below. Also, please check out all the other videos on Graphic Extras channel. Got thousands of other tutorials. Thank you much.